Welcome on down to a real quick MAME tutorial, fellow dazzlers and new players alike. Russell Juice are here giving you some insight on how to basically download and set up MAME. It's just a basic download and setup tutorial. I'm not going to go into anything advanced like cheats or anything like that or whatever. I do have a ROM tutorial. If you want to check that out, link will be in the description below. But let's kind of go over just downloading MAME, getting it set up, getting it ready to go. So, there's actually, I don't, as you know, if you've seen my previous tutorial videos, I don't use the official versions of MAME. I had used to have like a bajillion different types of memes, as you can see. I'm not actually going to be showing you how to set up the official release, so if you're looking for the official MAME dev release, this video is not going to cover that. I'll probably do something that shows how to set that up and work that just for the sake of having it there. But what we're going to do instead is we're going to go to this site right here. progettosnaps.net/MAME UI. Link will be in the description. I found out about this recently, and our friend here, Antopisa, I'm going to call him API. Andy Pizzle Italy makes these MAME UI versions and actually keeps them updated with all of MAME's updates, because MAME always updates. That's why you need to have, like, that's why, like, there's always this whole thing about ROM sets and updating your ROMs, because as emulation goes forward, new, you know, things may be dumped that will change how ROMs are. Anyways, so what you want to do here is you want to download the one that works for your system, so hit that 64-bit for my system. Now, it downloads as a 7Z file, so you are going to need something like WinRAR or 7Z to get that extracted. So let's go ahead and pop back into our downloads folder. And this is going to be from scratch, so I'll show you like how everything works. And I got to find out where that is. Oh, there it is. So let's go ahead and extract files. Okay. Alright, so now we've got our MAME here. Let's go ahead and crack that open. And as you can see, you already got all your basic folder setup, artwork, background stuff, I think that's what that is, plugins, ROMs, samples, all that stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and grab a couple ROMs from my collection here. Let's just pretend that we're downloading and installing them. If you're wondering on that, I'll get you on that in a second, so let me just go ahead and... Alright, so I've dropped the ROM in here. It's a good old MK2. I actually haven't seen if there's an update for Mortal Kombat 2, so hopefully there isn't. Let's just go ahead and crack that open. So, when you're dealing with like most versions of MAME, it's pretty much just going to be like that. It's going to be in a zip file or a 7-zip. You can just extract it and boom, you're good to go. I think MAME UI FX is really the only one that actually needed you to set up an install path for some reason, which is why I ended up looking into other versions of MAME. Speaking of MAME UI FX, that project actually got discontinued, I believe, and then I ended up finding out about the Progetto Snaps one that we have. And okay, so we've got MAME up and running. It took a little bit longer than I thought it would to get that going. So we dropped in Mortal Kombat. So if you remember from the good old MAME tutorial, we just type in the game that we dropped in without having to search for it or wait for it to look for ROMs. Let's check. Where are you hiding? Here we go. Now on default, MAME is gonna go to full screen. You can of course set that. I'll kind of like show you where you can go to change that stuff around. And the machine's gonna load. And there you go. By default, MAME will use the Control-Alt-Shift buttons and the arrow keys. So what I like to do is go to Input General, Player 1 Controls, and I'll just set up globally like this. Whoops. Might help if I do it right. If you are putting this in a folder where you already have a bunch of MAME versions and they're all sharing the same folders and config files, you shouldn't have to do this. It will pick up that there's already an existing config file. In fact, I might even ask you if you want to overwrite, and of course you say, no, I don't. That way, you'll have all your buttons set up across all your games. And then, of course, you can always go input this machine if you want to input specific buttons for that. And then, you know, if you've got a game pulled up, you want to put it into window mode, just hold Alt, push Enter. There you go. So if you're wondering about how to do things like to change your options so it always appears in a windowed mode, you want to be going to your properties, and then you want to go to display, and then you can click to run in a window. Start at max, we'll put it as a big window instead of as a smaller window. Then you hit apply, and I'll go over like all the that stuff in another video, but that's basically just, this is basically just how to get it set up, how to get it going. And then if you want to add like things like, you know, cabinet snapshot and stuff like that, F12 is your default snapshot key, so once you do that, MAME will just use the first snapshot it finds in your snapshot directory for your game as the snapshot preview for the game. Cabinet and all that fun stuff is going to be, that's going to be what these folders are for. I honestly don't know if there's a cabinet folder that already comes with MAME, but you know, it could be as simple as adding in. Of course, I'll go over that stuff later. So you may be wondering, well, geez, Razzle, that's great, but where do I get resources for this? So Progetto Snaps is a great place. There's this site here called RetroROMs. It's free to join. You only limit it to 100 downloads a month, though, if you don't pay for a premium plan. And it's a great place to get resources. You know, it's all things retro. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I think you can, you don't need me to spell it out for you, right? So that's pretty much it. Navigating around RetroROMs is simple and easy. So I'll kind of walk you through that. So you just pop in there. I'm already on this site, Razzle Geostar, the one and only. You want to go to your downloads, you go to downloads. You've got a bunch of stuff in here. You go to MAME, and then you can find all kinds of stuff. Updated ROMs, updated, these will have the updated sets as well. So if you're constantly downloading new ROM, new MAME versions from Progetto Snaps, and he does actually pace with decently well with the official MAME releases, you can come here and grab those. You can even grab chits from here and stuff, and BIOS, and all the useful resources you need for running MAME. But that's gonna be about it. Like I said, there is a tutorial that shows on how to install MAME ROMs, chits, and BIOS in the description if you want to check that out. I will be going over other ways of running MAME, and again, I'll take a closer look at the official release of MAME for those of you who want to do things, you know, more by the book and with the official release. So that being said, my name is Russell Joestar. I probably yammered for way too long. I'm still trying to get used to doing these tutorials in a good cut time. So if you guys got any tips or feedback you want to send to help me improve on that, feel free to let me know. I'm always willing to listen to what you guys have to say. So once again, thanks. And if you want to help the channel out, I know you get tired of hearing this, but this channel is not sponsored by Shadow Legends. We're not doing that. but good ways to support us, subscribe, like, again, leaving comments. We do read comments. We do try to interact with comments if you guys have any, again, tips to help me do these tutorials a little bit better. Or if you just have any games you want to see, like if you're like, hey, when are you going to play Gauntlet? You know, let me know. I'll take a look at that and start making content for it. We also have our Patreon if you want to help support the channel. We don't really have very many any rewards really set up, but we're trying to figure out something. Trying to figure out something to help you guys feel, you know, rewarded for supporting the channel. And then we have Ko-fi if you want to make a one-time donation, because Patreon doesn't let you do one-time donations for whatever stupid reason. And of course, follow the manager's Twitter at AuthorNico, and I think that's pretty much good. It's been a while since I've actually ran through all that. I'm done rambling, so my name is Russell Joestar. I'll see you guys next time. Take care.